I'm very interested in my work to sort of blur the lines between past, present, and future, and I think sound has a way to achieve this. Hi, my name is Ulrik Lopez. I am an artist from Puerto Rico and Mexico, based at Mexico City. I am a queer resident at Delfina Foundation for the collecting practice. My work is very interested in the sort of twin fields of archaeology and anthropology, and how they sort of like study, collect, and observe cultural material production. I study lean into the ones from Mesoamerica and the Caribbean region, and they're usually like a trampoline, or I see them as a trampoline to address my interest in, you know, the ritual, craft as a means of exploring its way to convey knowledge, orality, and as well sort of like this, the way these types of mediums sort of address the imagined and the unobserved, and how those lines sort of like become blur. And while I'm here at Delfina, I've been working with a couple of archives in different institutions. I'm very interested in how these objects, what happens to these objects when they become collected, the places they're moved to, and sort of try to sort of activate them outside of the spaces. So here I'm working with two institutions, the British Museum, collection, specifically the one from Mexico, and as well some things in the Horniman Museum, which has a large collection of instruments. With the British Museum collection, I'm very interested in several objects they have from Mayan and Aztec origin. Specifically, I'm really focused on some obsidiana mirrors that they have. These were brought and collected for like the relationship to esoteric practices, but I'm very interested in like their origin, which is related to Tezcatlipoca, which is the deity sort of like called Espejo Humeante, which can be translated to smoked mirror or humid mirror. And I'm very, you know, interested in how this object that is used for reflection and reflecting oneself, sort of like a way in which I want the museum to reflect on itself and on its practices of having these objects in its collection. Another thing I was researching while I'm here was instruments in pre-colonial times. I've been studying an ethnomusicologist from Mexico and Mexico called Samuel Martí, and specifically his instruments related to wind and clay. So for example, I brought this sort of like inspired Mayan flute from Mexico, which I'm gonna use to play certain things to a couple of objects in these two collections that I'm working with, to sort of address again, you know, the different values of aesthetics within music in pre-colonial times and how they changed after colonial contact.